Hi all, welcome back to the channel. So in today's session we are going to understand what are the aggregate function in SQL Server and why we are using it. So see, aggregate functions is basically used to perform the calculations and computation in SQL Server database table. So SQL Server has provided a lot of the aggregate functions which we are going to understand one by one. The very first what we are going to discuss is the count function. The count function is basically used to return the number of the records which are available in the table. So for demonstration purpose, we have this table. Let's go ahead and check how many records we have and what kind of the data we have. See, this kind of the data we have. We have ID, name, gender and salary. Okay, and total number is 17. Let's suppose we have, we wanted to know how many records we have in this table. Okay, for that we can use a select count asterisk from this. So this is the syntax of using the count function. And this way you can use, and it will return you the number of the records available in the table as of now. Now there is one more thing. If you wanted to see, if you perform the count, we have performed the count on the total records. Asterisk means the all the records, all the rows, okay, all the columns. If I wanted to perform the count or on the particular column, then what will happen? Okay, let's see. If I wanted to perform the count on this gender column, where in this column one column one value is null, so what it will return? So I wanted to perform the count on the column gender, so what it will give? Let's understand. Total is 17 records and it is giving is 19. That means the count on the specific column will return the number of non-null values over the column, over that specified column. Okay, so it will return the non-null values. So non-null values are 16 records out of the total 17 records. Okay, what will happen if we perform the distinct? If you wanted to perform the wanted to get the distinct count of all the records, but you wanted to know the distinct rows. Okay, so let's say the salary is the column which will decide the rows are distinct or not. So I wanted to see the distinct salary, the count of all the count of the rows having the distinct salary. For that we will use the count and then distinct salary from this table. So this is the syntax for that. So total is 5 rows. Okay, so out of the 17 record, out of the 17 records we have only 5 records which is having the distinct salary. If you wanted to recheck, you can go and check, like 60,000, 60,000, 60,000, 60,000, 60,000. We have repeated salaries here. So unique records having the unique salary is only 50, only 5 records. Okay, this way we can use the count. Most of the people we know that we use the count asterisk only. We can use the count distinct specified column and we can perform the count on the particular column as well. Okay, now next aggregate function is sum. So sum is basically used to get the all non-null values of the column. Okay, so if I wanted to get the sum of all the salaries, so what it will give? It will give me the salary of the total salary of all not null value. Just in case if we have the null column here in anywhere in the salary, that will not be calculated. Okay, let's go ahead and execute it. So it is giving me the sum of total salaries. Okay, and just in case, as we know that we have only distinct salary, 5 records having the distinct salary, and I wanted instead of total records of total salary, I wanted the distinct, the total of the distinct salary. Okay, so in that case we can use the distinct salary. I wanted the sum of the salaries which are distinct in this table. For that we use the sum and then distinct salary. So see, the result set is now different. It contains the 13,500 okay. So this much of record we got. And then we have the next aggregate function, that is average function. So average is also AVJ. This is the function name and then the braces. See, all the functions is having the braces. Okay, and here if we wanted to, as I have the salary, I wanted to get this average of the salary, then I need to put the need to specify the column name here. That's all. It's just simple. And then we will get the average. As we know that salary is not a distinct, we have a repeated columns as well. We have repeated values for the salary column and we wanted the average of the distinct column. So So in that case, similarly, we can use the distinct salary inside the average function, and then we will get the average of the distinct salary. Okay, here. Then the next aggregate function we'll talk about is the minimum aggregate function. This will give the minimum of the value. So among all the 17 records, the I wanted to get the minimum salary, whose employee is having the minimum salary, and what is the minimum salary, not whose employee, what is the minimum salary we got, we have in this table. So for that we have this function, minimum salary. So the minimum salary here is 100. Okay, and similarly we have another function which is counterpart of it, that is maximum. I wanted to check which one is the maximum salary, what is the maximum salary. Then we have 60,000 is the maximum salary and 100 is the minimum salary. So these are the aggregate functions which we often use in the SQL Server. And so like we have understood count, count asterisk, distinct, count, and then we have average, use the average function, we use the minimum, maximum functions. So these are the common aggregate function which is used in the SQL Server. I hope you like the video. In case you have any questions, please comment in the comment box. Thank you and have a nice day.